good deal with gravity, but then there's your shaky hand. Next time you want a steady follow pan, loop a rubber band around the handle of your tripod, and use that as the handle. The rubber band will absorb any shakes coming from your hand, so that you get a much steadier motion. Steady cams can be pricey, but you can convert a tripod into a fairly effective one. First, detach one of the legs from the center pole, and tighten the other two legs to the center pole. Now extend the neck all the way and turn the quick release plate 90 degrees. Voila, a simple and effective Steadicam for running shots and cinematography. This works using the camera and the tripod as a counterweight, which offsets movements from the rest of the tripod. Thanks to Will Merrick for coming up with this idea, originally called the Merrycam. If your tripod has a removable monopod, you can convert it into an even simpler Steadicam by holding it upside down. Your footage will be upside down, of course, but you can flip it in post-production with any good video editor. If your camera has a hot shoe mount on the top, you can use this and you won't have to worry about flipping the video. This method uses the camera as a counterweight, so it's lighter and more compact. Consider extending the monopod because the further away the weight is, the more effective it will be. This method is great for low shots or even out the side of a car. If you can't afford $50 for a microphone boom pole, consider using a monopod instead. Mount the microphone to the end and extend the monopod all the way. Just be careful not to break the monopod when you get into the really thin segments. If you want those nice smooth shots that you can get with the slider, try putting some furniture pads under the legs of your tripod. You can get ones that work on carpet or hard surfaces, and they're quite effective.